Hi everyone, and welcome to another video from the MCAT team here at Shemmassian Academic Consulting. I'm Vikram Shaw, and in this video series, we'll be answering some commonly asked questions about the MCAT. Today, we'll be discussing several reasons why cars might be your worst scoring section on the MCAT. Many students, whether they're just starting their MCAT preparation or are months into their journey, are apprehensive of cars. The critical analysis and reasoning section, more often referred to as CARS, is essentially a test of verbal reasoning. You may have encountered similar sections when you took the ACT or SAT. However, the questions presented on the MCAT CARS section tend to have a few major differences. Questions on the MCAT CARS section include passage-based questions only, questions based on long-form written passages, and each passage contains 5 to 6 questions. In contrast to standardized test questions you may have seen in high school, there are no standalone test questions within the MCAT CARS section. Each and every CARS question is associated with a passage, and there are, on average, 5 to 6 questions presented with every passage for a total of 53 questions within a section. This unique format can make this seemingly simple verbal reasoning section extremely challenging. You might be practicing one MCAT CARS passage after another and not seeing any improvement. In the next few minutes, we'll discuss several reasons why CARS might be your worst section on the MCAT. Reason number one, the other MCAT sections test your content knowledge. The other three sections include chemistry and physics, or CP, biology and biochemistry, or BB, and psychology and sociology, or PS. These sections test students' knowledge of scientific content and require knowing quite a bit of content knowledge. The amount of content knowledge tested on each subsection varies. But given that these subjects also carry significant overlap with most pre-med courses, you probably already know a lot of the information from the undergraduate classes you've taken. Simply knowing the content knowledge without applying any particular strategy may be enough to lead you to score a 125 or even higher on a particular subsection. In other words, your content knowledge can overpower your strategy deficiency and allow you to score reasonably well despite not having an effective MCAT test-taking strategy. So what does this mean for your CARS score? If your scores on the three content-based sections are consistently higher than the score on your CARS section, then your pre-existing content knowledge is likely helping to keep your science section scores afloat. However, there may still be a larger underlying strategy weakness that's deflating all four of your subsection scores and impacting your CARS score the most. Reason two, CARS deliberately excludes any outside content knowledge. In contrast to the three science sections, the CARS section will only test you on the passage that's provided. In other words, you're tested on what you get. This means that all of the questions that are associated with the passage should only be answered using information from the text and without using any outside knowledge at all. It's very easy to forget this fact when answering CARS questions. Often, students will bring their prior knowledge into a CARS passage. This might include knowledge about a historical event or a historical figure, or even a definition of a vocabulary word. It can be a major pitfall for a CARS section score, especially if the author of a CARS passage is arguing against a commonly held belief or opinion. As a result, it's critically important to understand the main idea of each passage and exclude any outside knowledge when answering the questions. As a side note, one of the most common questions we get from students is how to decide on the best answer for CARS when you've narrowed it down to 2 remaining answer choices. We often hear students tell us that they always get to this point and then choose the incorrect answer. To fix this, we recommend 2 different exercises. The first, highlight the direct text evidence that supports each answer choice and simply choose the answer choice with more highlighted evidence. And number 2, count the number of assumptions or pieces of external information you need to arrive at the answer choice for both answer choices. You should choose the answer choice that requires you to make the smallest number of assumptions. To demonstrate this, let's say that, for example, an obviously fake question asks, "What's the weather like outside?" And let's say the passage says, "The trees were frosty." You would need to make only one assumption. The trees were frosty because it's cold outside. If you're making more assumptions, you're at risk of moving away from the passage information. For example, what if you say the trees were frosty because we're located in the northern hemisphere, so therefore the weather is cold? Here you're making two assumptions. Based on the passage information, all we can reasonably deduce is that it's cold outside, but there's no indication that we're located in the northern hemisphere. The MCAT's tricky and will use small details like this to try and confuse you. While it might not be this obvious in CARS passages, if you keep this framework in mind, you'll start to see where they try to trick you. Reason number three, absorb the main idea. If you're not doing well on CARS, this doesn't mean that you're not an effective reader. It's much more likely that there's a weakness in your CARS strategy. The nature of CARS questions require that you thoroughly understand the main idea and supporting arguments of each passage. The passages that are chosen and adapted for the MCAT usually have main ideas with lots of nuance. If you're only reading the text at a surface level, you'll be missing this nuance, along with the questions that might test you on them. One strategy we suggest to students struggling with main idea is to pretend they're reading the passage to a younger relative or friend and will have to explain the passage to that person afterwards. In other words, as they read the passage, they should force themselves to focus more on larger ideas, transition points, and big picture shifts. If you need to know a small detail, the question will direct you back to the specific point in the passage where you can find the answer. On your first read, you need to primarily focus on understanding the main ideas of each paragraph and of the passage as a whole. You should also have a good grasp on how the paragraphs relate to one another and how the author is forming an argument throughout the course of the passage. Reason number four, apply the information from the passage correctly. Along with understanding the main idea as you read the passage, it's also crucial that you correctly use the information within the passage to answer questions. The test writers love to trip students up by using the right words in the wrong way. They'll use information or direct quotes from the passage that students recognize as familiar and want to choose. However, they'll alter the context or specific words in a way that makes the answer incorrect. Be sure that if you choose an answer choice, you know exactly what it's saying. A great check is to reread the question one more time to ensure your answer choice actually answers the question before moving on to the next one. What students often find is that after they've spent a minute or 2 minutes trying to answer a question, they may have forgotten what the question is actually asking in the first place. So in conclusion, there are several reasons why your CARS subsection score might not be as high as you would like it to be. To begin to understand why CARS is your worst MCAT section, it's worth looking at other factors such as your scores on the science subsections and your approach to reading CARS passages and answering associated questions. In addition, if you'd identify a strategy gap on the CARS section, fixing this gap might allow you to simultaneously improve your scores on other sections of the exam that you may have simply been overpowering with your content knowledge. Now that you understand why strategy is so important for the CARS section, we hope you'll be inspired to redouble your efforts towards finding an effective strategy that works for you. If you invest the time and effort now into finding that strategy, it'll pay big dividends in the future. We strongly encourage you to check out our MCAT CARS strategy video from our 528 series, as that provides several high-yield strategies you can use to work on improving your CARS score. We hope you enjoyed this video. Please click on links below to sign up for our free MCAT question of the day. You can also find free content guides for every section of the MCAT on our site, and we hope you, like thousands of other pre-med students, find these incredibly useful in your preparation. Happy studying!